everybody. This is Christopher with AG Productions, and welcome to another product review. Today we're going to be talking about a product I was asked to review. It's the Warp 9 painting DVD made by Girl Painting right here on YouTube. Now, if you've never seen this DVD set before, or this DVD, I guess, because it's really not a set because there's not more than one of them, but if you've never seen this DVD before, click on the link in the video description. You'll be taken over to her channel page right to the video where you can download the DVD. All right, now, let's just jump right in and get to the review. Is it a good DVD? Yes, it is, for beginners. All right, I need to caveat that. It is a great DVD for the beginning miniature painter. Someone who has, I would say, if they've been in the hobby less than 2 or 3 months, this would be a great DVD for them. It covers various techniques of base coating, washing, dry brushing, and highlighting by layering, as well as doing a basic base for a miniature. Now, the production quality itself is okay. It's not fantastic, but if it's a one-person show, it's not that bad. The techniques that are covered are fairly well done. They're in-depth. There is a lot of actual instruction in the DVD set, so there's very little area where there are gaps of no talking. It's pretty much filled with speaking instruction throughout the entire set, which is very good considering that I just got finished watching another set that didn't have any instruction in it whatsoever, but we'll get there in the next review. Like I said, it's a very decent set. Definitely I would recommend it for the newer painters out there. If you've never picked up a miniature before, if you're fairly new to the game and you're really just used to kind of base coating the model and you're not really even sure how to do that well, definitely a good DVD. To give you some comparisons, if we take a look at some of the other DVD sets on the market and kind of compare between the two, we can kind of get an idea of what we're looking at. I would give you a comparison between Jeremy's DVD, but there's no comparison because this is not meant for beginners. This is meant for people who have been in the hobby for quite some time and are looking to step into the realm of realism. So that's, we kind of chunk that DVD to the side. Compared to the Hot Lead DVD set, this one we can kind of do a comparison because the Hot Lead DVD really takes the miniature painter from a basic paint job, the very simplest basic painting you can do, all the way through some very, very nice master level painting works. Compared to this, the Warp 9 DVD set is not as good. But at the same time, the Warp 9 DVD is only one DVD. It's 55 minutes long. This is 8 hours long, and it's $40. So, you know, take your pick. Plus, if you're a beginning painter, if you've never really gotten into any sort of advanced techniques or anything like that, if all you're used to doing is base coating your miniatures, I would recommend the Warp 9 DVD over the Hot Lead DVD, simply for the fact that if you get this, you're going to be overwhelmed, whereas if you go with the Warp 9 DVD set, you're going to get little bits of information at a time. You can practice those, and then when you're ready to move to a new level, then you can move into this, okay? This would be something for somebody who's been in the hobby, I would say, for at least 6 months or longer, and they're used to doing the basic techniques of base coating, washing, dry brushing, and layering, okay? Now, if we compare it to, let's say, this, the Privateer Press Core Techniques video that we reviewed several months ago, maybe even closer to a year ago, it's a far superior DVD than this is. The reason being, the instructions in this are, how to put it, they're just not very good. And Alexandra's instructions are, they're fairly decent. They're very in-depth, and she actually really explains what she's doing, basically stroke for stroke, whereas in this DVD set, it's kind of a given that you sort of already have an idea of what some of the techniques are and things like that, you'll be given the task of, say, they'll be explaining washing a miniature. And basically what they'll say is, just paint the wash into the cracks and the crevices. And it's like, okay, well, how do you do that? And that's where the Warp 9 DVD excels over this one, because it actually explains the how of the miniature painting instead of just the what. All right, now, let's see here. Ah, these. Dennis and Brian. We have not reviewed these because I was actually asked not to review them by the creator of the DVD set. Apparently, his DVD burner is broken, and he can't actually make these anymore. So, can't really do a review on them. But I can say the production quality in this versus the production quality in the Warp 9 DVD are basically the same. This is about an hour-long disc versus the Warp 9 DVD set, which is about 55 minutes. Both of them cover techniques fairly well, and they're both relatively equal in their instructional value, if you will. All right? Now, we have the Painting Wizards Workshop, which we have already done a review for as well. Compared to this, I would actually say that this is a superior product than the Warp 9 DVD. The reason for that is that while the Warp 9 DVD set does go more in-depth in the things that it does cover, this VHS tape is only 40 minutes, but it covers a wider variety of subjects, a far, far wider variety of subjects, all right, including actually assembling the miniatures, which is not really covered in the Warp 9 DVD, because the Bretonian Archer that was used is just a single-piece model. It's just one of the old models out of, I don't remember which one of the sets it was. I think it's set number from set 6 of the Warhammer fantasy box set, where it's basically just an archer model that you clip out, you attach to the base, and you're done. All right, it's very similar to like the goblins from the Battle for Skull Pass box set. It's just a one-piece model, so there's not really a lot of assembly that you can do. All right, but again, this VHS tape covers a far wider set of material in a shorter amount of time. And so if you're a newer painter and you want to get a wide array of stuff that's available, I would go with this. If you want more in-depth instruction, I would go with the Warp 9 DVD. Now, that being said, this is $5. The Warp 9 DVD right now is free. Okay? And so it's kind of a toss-up, and they're both exceptional DVDs or VHS tapes, depending on which one you get. And honestly, I would recommend them both. Pick them both up. But as far as the Warp 9 DVD set goes, it's a great set. I would definitely recommend it for beginning painters. As far as any of the quote-unquote cons of the DVD, there are really only a couple. First of all, if you're like me, you're a computer dork. You have no clue about anything computer-wise, and it took me about a week and a half to figure out how to take the DVD, or the file that you have to download, and get it onto a DVD so you can watch it. I had no clue how to do it. I think that providing a set of step-by-step instructions on how to do that would be very helpful, all right? And in fact, once I got it onto a DVD, I found it to be really, really nice, because what I was expecting was a series of, like, MPEG videos or something like that, and what it turned out to be, it was an actual watchable DVD with menus and everything. And so it worked out very nicely. Now, and so basically it works very well, but I think that a little bit of instruction step by step as to how to get from file download format to actual DVD format would be helpful. Aside from that, as far as the DVD itself goes, there's only two things I would change. Number one, I would change the background. Everything is done on a white background, and I actually had to learn this the hard way when we started doing DVDs. Anytime you use a white background and you're painting miniatures in front of it, the light reflects off the white background and comes into your eyes at such a harsh amount that it actually washes the colors off the model, and it makes them appear much darker than they actually are. This makes things very difficult to see. And that brings up problem number two, in that the miniature appears in the DVD to be very, very dark, and some of the highlights are so subtle that it's kind of difficult to see them. And so I think that a lighter color choice would have helped, but at the same time, it may be that that darkness and that inability to see the different highlights was caused by the intensity of the light reflecting off the surface of the table that was being used. So in future videos, I would suggest doing some sort of background table, be it a black, a brown, maybe a dark blue, something that is not going to reflect light as much as the white would, because the white background really, really does detract from the quality of the DVD set. But other than that, and the lighter color choices that I would have gone with a lighter color choice because it makes things easier to see. But again, the inability to see the highlights and things like that might be due to the camera problem of having that light white background. Okay, so those are really the only two major issues that I had any kind of a problem with as far as the production value goes. Other than that, great DVD set. I highly recommend it. Definitely jump down there into the video description and go take a look at the Warp 9 Basic Painting DVD. Alright? Now, I hope you guys have enjoyed this this DVD review. The next review that we do will hopefully be out. I don't know if I'm going to do it this weekend. I may save it for next week. It just kind of depends. I'm hoping to do a series or an episode of Ask a Painter this weekend. And I don't want to do more than one video on a single day. So we'll probably end up doing that. But the next on the chopping block is going to be this right here. And I really, really don't want to do it. But hey, it could be fun because you guys are going to see a rant like you have never seen when we get to this DVD. You think I rip on Games Workshop? You ain't seen nothing yet. This is going to be that's going to be a fun one in some ways. I don't really know why I'm afraid of it. I've already watched the thing. I've already gone through all the pain that I'm going to have to go through. So now I just get to vent, which is going to be fun. anyway, that's it for today, guys. If you have any questions, put them in the comment section down below. I hope you've enjoyed it. God bless you all. Have a fantastic rest of the day. And I'll see you all in the next video. Bye-bye.